Lauren Crosby. She's a pediatrician at Lapeer Pediatrics in Beverly Hills to weigh in on this. What do you think? I mean, here's what this guy's saying, you know, let him out in the world. Don't be so confining and controlling, you know, give him opportunity to mature.
Right. Independent.
Well, right. And be independent. Well, I think number one is they're partly looking back to the idyllic old age, you know, the 60s, 50s, 60s, early 70s, when it was the norm. Things changed and it became not the norm for a lot of reasons. I think one is kids didn't have, they started to become more involved in things, like more involved in sports and more involved in things where they're shuttled around more and taken this and that. And so they're not just home
roaming. Getting,
and also if they are home, they're also not out roaming because they're in front of a screen a lot of the time too. And that's a big issue also. So, and then the age of kids and when it is safe to do it, like for this family, I mean, it's a 10-year-old boy watching a 6-year-old girl.
A 6-year-old, that's
pretty
young.
And I actually don't think that's appropriate. And I watched a whole bunch of videos and interviews with them and the little girl. Mm-hmm. She looks like she's 4. Mm-hmm. And I think it's too young.
But what has changed? I mean, aside from kids having different activities now, crime has not changed. Because if you look back at crime statistics, there hasn't been this jump in abductions that parents fear.
I think that's a false thing that
Where's
they're afraid
the fear
of.
Coming
I don't think
from?
That's the big thing. Some of it is actual just general traffic safety. Traffic has increased a lot. And I don't really think that a 6-year-old should be out there. They don't know how to cross a street. Mm-hmm. I think that if it's in a neighborhood and a child under the age of 7, they don't have cause and effect. They don't understand if you look at it developmentally. They don't have the logic to be able to do this. Mm-hmm. So I think that's out. 7 to 10, depending on your neighborhood, if it's very structured and it's something where you have done it with them many, many times and they know the area and you know it's a relatively pretty safe area, I think that there are some boundaries that you could establish so that they can get to know their neighborhood. But I think that parents also are very busy and they're not out there walking around with their kids. Two parents are both working now and they're not showing them their neighborhoods and teaching them about it. I used to walk. My grandma walked me all everywhere. Mm-hmm. I knew everything. I knew how to cross streets. I knew how to... Because I was taken out so many times, I was confident in doing it.
But this is what we're really talking about, though, right? Age and also maturity.
Maturity.
Because kids are
important.
Different, at, you know, mature at different ages. Yeah. And I'm sure even in your practice, you see, as you said, a 6-year-old that acts like a 4-year-old, or even a 6-year-old that acts like an 8-year-old.
Yes.
And
so
that really makes a difference.
But can't they, difference.
But I mean, when you talk about developmentally, I mean, it almost forces maturity on kids when they do feel a sense of independence, when they do feel that they have their own, you know, realm and they can roam.
It does, except for the brain developmentally can't always get to a certain point yet. So like a kid who's especially under the age of 7, we just know that they aren't going to have the thinking, no matter what. They're not going to be as safe. They're not going to think properly. Older than that, some of them can learn it. But I do think kids learn it eventually anyway. I mean, my kids were busy and they weren't out roaming the streets and they had sports or gymnastics or... And they're older now, but, you know, when they were 12 to 15, the 15-year-old and the 12-year-old would learn the L.A. Metro bus, and they were going around L.A.
Wow.
And they,
you put them on a Metro bus?
They started first by their school, because their school was very far from the house. And the 15-year-old, they're both bright boys, and I knew that they're good and responsible kids, and they would go together. And they would Metro home, or they take the blue bus in Santa Monica home, and they go to the promenade, and they get home.
Yeah.
And then they learned. So,
but when you prevent your kids from doing that, right?
You know?
If you're 12 and up, and you still fear that your kids shouldn't be roaming around by themselves, whether it's because of traffic or other factors, does that impede their development
and
at some point? Because we do see a lot of kids that sometimes get into adulthood and still need help. Yeah.
No, I think it's good. I think 12 and up is a really good age to start. I do. Under 12, and still there are some really immature 12-year-olds.
Mm-hmm.
So again, it is also common sense with some of it too.
Free range parenting and helicopter parenting.
They're the complete opposites.
These new terms. Like I said, we just knew latchkey.
I'm a free ranger. I was free range.
I feel like I was free range.
Really?
Too,
yeah.
Different
I was
place.
Like, but then
look what happened to us.
All right, Dr. Crosby, thank you very much.